This is the sixth session of the Advances in Post-Harvest Technology of Fruits and Vegetables, and the topic which we'll be covering today is importance and scope of post-harvest management of fruits and vegetables in Indian economy. Introduction. India has been bestowed with a wide range of climate and geographical conditions, such as most suitable for growing various kinds of horticultural crops such as fruits, vegetables, flowers, nuts, spices and plantation crops. Fruits and vegetables are an important supplement to the human diet as they provide the essential minerals, vitamins and fibers required for maintaining health. Fruits and vegetables account for nearly 90% of the total horticultural production in the country. India is now the second largest producer of fruits and vegetables in the world and is the leader in several horticultural crops, namely mango, banana, papaya, cashew nut, areca nut, potato and okra. Its horticultural production has increased significantly over the last two decades, and as per the final estimates, by 2014 and 15 it has increased to about three times since 1991 and 92, and about twice, that is 1.90 compared to the production in 2001-2. As per National Horticultural Database published by the National Horticultural Board during 2014-15, India produced 86.6 million metric tons of fruits and 169.478 million metric tons of vegetables. The area under cultivation of fruits stood at 6.11 million hectares, while vegetables were cultivated at 9.542 million hectares. Talking about the scope and status in particularly in India, it is a matter of satisfaction that we are second largest producer of vegetables and fruits, and our presence in global market is significant. The development achieved in the horticulture sector is indicative of the fact that there is growing demand for horticultural produce. The past experience has been rewarding for enhanced output from the investment. Availability of timely, robust information in this sector will certainly improve the socio-economic conditions of Indian citizen by providing self-reliance besides environmental protection. Scope. The production and marketing of fruits and vegetables must delve into production aspects, marketing aspects, processing and manufacturing aspects. There are tremendous production of fruits and vegetables in a shorter period. Therefore, to avoid the post-harvest losses and to increase substantial returns to produce processors for off-season consumption, availability of cheap labor, government subsidy for cold storage and for processing units, convenience of roads in case of marketing and transport, availability of cans, bottles and other equipments at cheap rate, there is tremendous for export of processed products like jam, jelly, marmalades, pickles, etc., dehydrated and dried vegetables in addition to domestic demand in India. Status. In India, there is an overall increase in demand of fruits and vegetables, both in fresh and processed form. In view of difficulties, several research studies were taken up by agricultural scientists in the past. Then a central plan scheme called the Crop Estimation Survey of Fruits and Vegetables, a component of improvement of agricultural statistics, was implemented by the Directorate of Economics and Statistics of the scheme, was implemented by the Ministry of Agriculture and Farmers Welfare. In addition, there is a wide diversification in the production pattern globally. Improved production technologies such as hybrids, high yielding varieties, increased use of fertilizers and plant protection measurements have brought spectacular increase in the production of fruits and vegetables. Horticulture industry has emerged as an important sector for the diversification of agriculture and has established its credibility in improving farm income through increased productivity, generating employment, and its enhancing export besides providing household nutritional security. Area and production of fruits and vegetables. As a study, IASRI, as a study to test the development alternative methodology for estimation of area and production of horticulture crops, the study will be taken up in 8 states, namely Maharashtra, Andhra Pradesh, Karnataka, Tamil Nadu, Gujarat, Madhya Pradesh, Haryana and Himachal Pradesh. In each of these states, about 40% districts, out of the total number of districts covering about 70 to 80% of the total area under fruits and vegetables in the entire state, and the two districts out of the remaining districts covering about 20-30% of the total area under fruits and vegetables in the entire state will be undertaken for the study. Area assessment will be carried out for the selected crops in the selected districts of major states. The area under fruits in the country has increased from 4.01 million hectares in the year 2001 to 6.3 million hectares in the year 2014-15, and the area under vegetables has increased from 6.16 million hectares in the year 2001-2 to 9.30 million hectares in year 2014-15. Production of fruits and vegetables. India has witnessed voluminous increase in horticulture production over the last few years. Significant progress has been made in area expansion, resulting in higher production. Over the last decade, the area under horticulture grew up by the 2.7 per annum and annual production increased by 7%. During 2014-15, India produced 86,602 tons of fruits and 169,478 tons of vegetables. The highest annual growth of 9.5% is seen in fruits during 2014-15. The production of vegetables has increased from 58,532 tons to 169,478 tons since 1991-92 to 2014-15. Indian Meteorological Department (IMD) under the forecast agricultural output using space agro meteorology and land based observations FASEL project develops district level empirical agro meteorological yield models for different crops. Similar procedures will be followed for yield forecasting of vegetables crops. The All India production of fruits and vegetables. In year, All India production of fruits and vegetables and productivity of fruits and vegetables over the years is shown in the figure. That's all for this session. Thank you.